Yeah, go ahead, please.
I've said many times that the U.S. is doing far better than any other country when it comes to testing.
Yes.
Why does that matter? Why is this a global competition to you if everyday Americans are still losing their lives and we're still seeing more cases every day?
Well, they're losing their lives everywhere in the world. And maybe that's a question you should ask China. Don't ask me. Ask China that question, okay? When you ask them that question, you may get a very unusual answer. Yes, behind you, please.
What, sir, why are you saying that to me specifically?
I'm telling you. I'm not saying it specifically to anybody. I'm saying it to anybody that would ask a nasty question
that's
like that.
That's not a nasty question.
Please go ahead.
Why does it matter?
Okay. Anybody else? Please, go ahead in the back, please.
I have two questions.
No, it's okay.
But
we'll
you pointed to me. I have two questions, Mr.
Next.
President.
Next, please.
But you called on me.
I did, and you didn't respond, and now I'm calling on
sorry, I just
the young lady in the back, please.
I just wanted to let my colleague finish,
okay.
But can I ask you
ladies
a question,
and gentlemen,
please?
Thank you very much. Appreciate
but
it. Thank you very much.
Very, very ugly ending to that one-hour appearance by the president in the Rose Garden, refusing to answer our own White House correspondent, Kaitlan Collins' question, and going after another reporter, several reporters in the course of that one-hour exchange. Gloria, it was really awkward to see that unfold, and I give our White House correspondent, Kaitlan Collins, a lot of credit for deferring to that colleague of hers who was asking a reasonable question, and the president said to this Asian American, go ask China about that.
Well, I think I give the journalist a lot of credit because what she is saying is, are you being racist in asking that question of me? Now, he denied it, but you can judge for yourself, Wolf. There he was saying to her, ask China. Why would he do that? And, you know, I think this isn't the first time this has occurred from this president. And I think that, you know, she had a lot of guts in saying to him, are you asking me this? Because I, you know, because of my appearance and who I am.
Yeah, which was a fair question and a fair response. Kaitlan Collins is with us right now. Kaitlan, you were there on the scene. You know, give us your sense of what happened on several related issues. And as Gloria correctly points out, the president accusing the former president Barack Obama of committing the greatest crime, Obamagate, he keeps calling it. Although when pressed, what crime did he commit? He didn't have an answer for that. He said, stick around, maybe you'll see something in the next few weeks.
Yeah, Wolf, he said the answer to that question was obvious, though he did not state what it was if he feels it's so obvious. And, of course, a strange end there to the press conference where the president had called on me. I was letting my colleague Weijia Jiang from CBS finish her question, and then the president abruptly ended the press conference, did not let me ask my questions. We had multiple questions, of course, for the president. He had not called on us yet. And this was not only about testing, but also the president is facing questions about the coronavirus outbreak happening here at the White House and what he is going to do moving forward with his relationship with the vice president, who notably was not there, Wolf. I don't think that has ever happened in our time here at the White House, where the vice president has been here in Washington at the White House and not attended a press conference that the president was having. So clearly some kind of separation happening there. But then when the president was asked at the end, you know, what his point of this entire press conference was, to talk about testing and to talk about how his administration has ramped it up. And he repeatedly was talking about where the United States falls in the world ranking of who is doing the most testing not only, you know, overall, but also per capita. And when the reporter at the end was asking why that is such an important thing for him to stress, why does he keep talking about that as in, you know, a global ranking, basically, that's when he got irritated at the end when he was telling Weijia Jiang to ask China that answer to that question. And, Wolf, we had several other questions for the president, including about his own decisions that he's made, what he's going to do going forward after he decided not to self-quarantine, after his personal valet tested positive for coronavirus. We've seen several officials who came in contact with the vice president's press secretary decide to self-quarantine after they had sustained periods of contact, though that is not an option that the vice president himself is taking. And of course, Wolf, the other thing you noticed that was different in that press conference today out in the Rose Garden than what we've seen in any others is that the staffers are wearing masks, the ones you saw standing alongside the colonnade, even the Health and Human Services Secretary, Jared Kushner, another official that they've hired to come and help with testing. The guests were wearing masks, but the president himself was not wearing a mask. And we know previously when the CDC issued that guidance at the beginning of April, saying they believe people should cover their face when in public and they couldn't socially distance from others, that the president said he was not going to follow that. So the question is he also not going to follow this new requirement that staffers entering the West Wing should all be wearing masks? So a lot of questions to the president, Wolf, but he did not take any from CNN there at the end.
I want to bring in Brian Stelter right now, our media correspondent. Brian, at the very, very end of that one-hour appearance by the president in the Rose Garden, and you were watching, all of us were watching, it was really ugly. I'll play the clip once again. This is the CBS White House correspondent, Weijia Jiang. I'll play the clip. She asked a reasonable question and watch the president's response.
Why is this a global competition to you if everyday Americans are still losing their lives and we're still seeing more cases every day?
Well, they're losing their lives everywhere in the world. And maybe that's a question you should ask China. Don't ask me. Ask China that question, okay? When you ask them that question, you may get a very unusual answer. Yes, behind you, please.
What, sir, why are you saying that to me specifically?
I'm telling you, I'm not saying it specifically to anybody. I'm saying it to anybody that would ask a nasty question
like
that.
That's not a nasty question.
Please go ahead.
Why does it matter?
Okay. Anybody else?
All right. Then he had originally called on Kaitlan Collins, our White House correspondent. She was polite enough and did the journalistic right thing, let her colleague follow up, which is appropriate. I spent 7 years as a White House correspondent. We often let other White House correspondents do a follow-up question to the president at these kinds of events, just out of simple courtesy to our colleagues. And that's what Kaitlan Collins did. The president then wouldn't even address a question that she was ready to pose. But let me get your thoughts on that exchange the president had with the CBS White House correspondent.
Well, clearly the president was rattled enough to walk off because he didn't want to hear the questions from Kaitlan Collins and Weijia Jiang. And I think what we saw in that exchange with Weijia Jiang is something that has racial overtones. It is racist to look at an Asian American White House correspondent and say, ask China. This isn't happening in a vacuum. This is part of a pattern of behavior from the president that goes back many years. So he doesn't have the benefit of the doubt that someone might have if, for the first time ever in their life, they made a comment like that to a reporter. But the president has been rattled by Weijia Jiang's questions in the past. He has treated her and other female reporters differently in the past. And he's also had this pattern of reacting to minority journalists in a very specific and different way, Wolf. For example, a few years ago, President Trump said to April Ryan, a black correspondent, to follow up with the Congressional Black Caucus because he kind of just assumed they were friends. And here today, he's saying to a Chinese-born journalist, ask China. Now, of course, he says he was directing it. He would have said the same thing to anyone. But the pattern suggests otherwise. The pattern suggests a racial reaction to certain individuals in the press corps. And that's deeply, deeply disturbing. Let me just tell you Weijia Jiang's background for everybody who doesn't know. She's a White House correspondent for CBS, one of the best reporters on the beat. And she describes herself in her biography as a Chinese-born West Virginian. What a beautiful sentiment. Right? To be Chinese born and then to be a part of this country and to be from West Virginia and to describe yourself in that way. Normally, we wouldn't even be talking about her background. We wouldn't even be talking about her heritage. But it's come up because the president routinely targets reporters who are women and people of color. In this case, he targeted Weijia Jiang today, but this is a pattern. And as much as we are competitive in the press corps, I think it's important we show solidarity in moments like this and call out racial kind of reactions from the president.
And once again, her question was totally, totally fair. A serious, tough question, but
great
totally
question.
Fair question. And the president obviously didn't want to hear about that. Then he goes and attacks young journalist from CBS News, and I give her a lot of credit for the way she responded.